Hello guys, we just arrived in Bucharest. We are with Stéphane, Combremont just here. And how are you, Stéphane?
Hi everyone, I'm lucky and very pleased. You see some people from Switzerland, Lausanne and the hotel school, of course.
Yes.
So in this episode, we'll be all together with only French accent people.
So Stéphane, can you tell us where we're going now?
Now, yes, we are going to eat something.
Hello, Liliana.
Liliana,
how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Liliana is my girlfriend.
Oh.
Cheers for your visit.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us here. We're very happy to be here.
It's the second day here in Romania, and now we're going to discover Stéphane Combremont's business. Let's go!
When you finished school, it was in 1983. What did you do?
I was working in hospitality, the hotel, a couple of months, 6 months. After I was involved in the same hotel in the first network of cash register. So I started really working the cash register domain for something like 2-3 years. Apart in London, and after I would go back to Switzerland, where I tried to knock on the door of all my ex-colleague from the hotel school to see if they don't need one of my wonderful cash register. And one day I made an exhibition and a little conference in the hotel school with cash register and talking with different people. I said, well, eventually we're looking for somebody for in a computer department in the hotel school. We need staff, and I say, okay, I'm in. And I stayed 9 years in the hotel school in the computing department. After this, in the computing department, logistics, in a big distributor company. And this company, unfortunately, decided to relocate in Ireland. I had to stay in Switzerland for personal reasons. And I was very then upset with the world of computing. So I decided to do something which is completely opposite to stay in an office in front of a display. I have a friend in Switzerland who was managing 3 adventure parks. My girlfriend at this time was from Romania. So we decided a Saturday afternoon, let's make an adventure park in Romania. The fact that you have to sell your house, the house where were born my 3 kids, where I was more than 20 years, and it was a very nice surrounding. I knew that something like this, I could not find it again. You have to
leave your friends.
Leave your friends, your family. I didn't know exactly what this means, hopefully, because otherwise I don't know if I... But I did it. So we moved inside the country in Transylvania. And Brasov was very open to this idea. I just had to choose the location, to pay the rent, and to build the park. We did this in 2008. We opened a park with roughly 100 games. And since 10 years, we doubled the number of games. And it's a very successful business until today.
Wow.
So Stéphane found his laptop he had while he was at EHL, and it's an old Olivetti. You can see some pictures on the Chumi's walls, and it's 12.5 kilos.
Welcome in Stéphane Combremont's office.
So you went to the gala in Paris?
Yes.
So you tried to turn it on? Very first laptops used at EHL.
You want to make some columns, you push Alt F7.
So 1983 yearbook. So was this your crush at the time? Or?
Souvenir, huh? Let's...
Everything in black and white. Oh, I love it. Woo! Hey, Stéphane is here!
Wow,
such a bougas. Oh yeah, La Ferme at the time was crazy. It's exactly the same building as now.
all the guys from the rugby committee will be very happy to see that.
So this is quite amazing. It's the program for the Fête Finale. So it's EHL 1999, but that's the actual theme. That's not the year, that's the theme, because it was in 1983. Stéphane was telling me that for the program, he was head of logistics. It's 30 bucks for a bottle of champagne. Now nobody sells that to you under 120.
Afrim is very enthusiastic. He used to be the head of events of Fête Finale, so he's looked at with bright and shiny eyes.
It's crazy. So we're going with this, Stéphane? Where did you get this?
Bought it in Austria.
The castle was in fact Vlad the Impaler castle, and when Bram Stoker created the Count of Dracula in 1897 by his book, he actually inspired by Vlad the Impaler.
Wait for me, guys! Wait for me!
So, Stéphane, we ask every time the guest where we go to find a gift for the next guest, okay, for the next host. So the previous host selected this for you. It's a bottle of the 360 Jezelszek wine. Our host was Martin Jezelszek. And so every year they buy barrels and they made their own wine out of it. So this is the gift from Martin to you.
Thank you very much, Martin. You made a very good choice. Being the ex president of the club, Les Amis du Vin, the wine's friends club of the hotel school.
And so now the challenge for you is going to be to think of something for the next one.
Okay.
So now it's barbecue time. Let's start the meat.
We have the light.
So Loïck, we were talking about the challenge that Loïck has now about getting on the local radio station, and he asked Lilian, so the girlfriend of Stéphane, and she has a contact on the radio, so they're doing some calls
I'm
now. Today we're back at the park and we're gonna try the park this time, so
let's go. Not sure if I'm gonna survive today.
we have tracks for 10 years old kids.
We just finished the black line. It doesn't look like that, but it's super, super difficult, super physical. You have to do like to find the right balance all the time. Mm-hmm. And so it's not easy at all. So we're super exhausted right now. So how much do I have to pay you to redo the black line one more time, Loïc?
AP fees.
AP fee.
All right, so we just woke up from a little nap. We had a lot of fun at the Parque Aventura this afternoon, and now we're gonna go and meet Stéphane again, and we're gonna go out for a little dinner with him.
Yeah. We are in a restaurant in Brasov, and now is the time for the word of wisdom of Stéphane.
I think that the day you have an idea, the day you have a project, and you decide to go on, just go on. You will regret only what you didn't do. and this is what helped me in my life. It's why I did something like leaving Switzerland, going to Romania, making a project, something which did not exist in Romania, with the country. I didn't speak any words of Romanian, nothing, but I really did work very hard to finalize this project, and it was successful. So put your energy and go on.
Okay, as you can see, I'm in front of the Radio Brasov. My challenge is to speak on air. It's going to be very hard because we were in Brasov over the weekend, so everything was closed. So we are Monday morning, so I'm going to try to go and ask Radio Brasov if I can go on air.
So I'm very excited.
Amazing. Okay. So live from Radio Brasov.
Welcome everyone, welcome in Radio Brasov! This is Loïck on air, and I hope you're all doing well. Brasov is amazing! Thank you very much!
Yes! Amazing! Thank you very much, you made my day!
Hell yeah! I won the challenge, Radio Brasov on air today! Very, very cool! See you!
So we're gonna go up on the hill,
okay,
and check the city of Brasov out from the heights.
Yeah, from the top.
This is your first time climbing at the top of Brasov, Stéphane.
Yes, shame on me. After 10 years, I was waiting for the good opportunity. I find it.
And actually for this project we ask our friends to give us some names around the world. And actually I'm here with the father of Sabina, who gave us the name of Stéphane here in Romania, in Brasov.
Finishing the last details, and now we go to India!
Stéphane wants to show to us what gift he has made for our next host, Chanel and Maïs.
Something more symbolic. It's a carabiniere. It's something that I'm using daily because it's my safety, but it's also a link, a strong link between us, all of us, between the EHL, the alumni, and us as humans, coming from the same origin and with the same education.
It's already the end of episode 2. Thanks for watching, guys. We hope to see you on the next episode, episode 3. We're going to India.
Afrim is very happy to be in India.
Welcome to India.
Just taste everything.
The golden rule of networking.
India so far is absolutely amazing.